Module 1, Calculus of Vector Functions. Before starting this module, we go through some basic concepts of vector. First one, vector, then length of a vector, components, dot product and cross product. Vector. Vector is a quantity that associates both magnitude and direction. Vector, ഒരു quantityയാണ് അതിന് ഡയറക്ഷനും മാഗ്നിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും. എക്സാമ്പിൾ, എ ഫോഴ്സ് ആക്ടിങ് ഓൺ എ ബോഡി ഇസ് ആൻ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഫോർ വെക്ടർ. നെക്സ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണൻസ്. Let V be a vector in XYZ plane starting from P, X1, Y1, Z1 and Q, X2, Y2, Z2. Then A1 equal to X2 minus X1, A2 equal to Y2 minus Y1 and A3 equal to Z2 minus Z1 is called a components. It can be denoted as V equal to A1, A2, A3. That is, if V be a vector in XYZ plane, it has three components A1, A2, A3. Similarly, in XY plane, a vector has two components and is denoted by V equal to A1, A2. Next is length of a vector. Length of a vector is defined as norm and is denoted by mod A or norm A. If A equal to A1, A2, A3, where A1, A2, A3 are three components of this vector A, then mod A or norm A equal to root of A1 square plus A2 square plus A3 square. Norm means length of the vector. Next is dot product of two vectors A and B. A dot B equal to norm A into norm B cos theta, where theta is the angle between A and B, where A and B are two vectors. If A dot B equal to 0, then A and B are said to be orthogonal. Next is cross product of two vectors A and B. Cross product is defined by A cross B equal to determinant ijk A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, where A1, A2, A3 are the three components of the vector A and B1, B2, B3 are the three components of the vector B. Next we come to the topic, a vector field. Vector field is a function that associates a unique vector f of p with each point p in the region. Example, f of xy equal to minus yi plus xj. Consider the example, f of xy equal to minus yi plus xj. For xy equal to 1 minus 1, f equal to I plus j. For ordered pair 2, 3, f equal to minus 3i plus 2j. For ordered pair 4, 5, f equal to minus 5i plus 4j. These three vectors are vectors corresponding to this ordered pair points with respect to the vector field minus yi plus xj. This is the definition of the vector field. That is, vector field is a function that associates a unique vector f of p with each point p in the region. Next is continuity of vector function. A vector function v of t is said to be continuous at t equal to t naught if it is defined in some neighborhood of t naught and limit t tends to t naught v of t equal to v of t naught, where v of t equal to v1 of t, v2 of t, v3 of t, where v1, v2, v3 are the three components of the vector v of t. It also can be written as v1 of t I plus v, which is equal to v1 of t I plus v2 of t j plus v3 of t k. That is, v of t is continuous at t naught if and only if its three components are continuous at t naught. That is, or function v of t or a vector function v of t or a point t naught il continuous aano engil limit t tends to t naught v of t equal to v of t naught exist cheyum in some neighborhood of t naught. That means t naught center aaki ulla oru circle il, that is the neighborhood, t naught center aaki ulla circle il v of t equal to limit t tends to t naught v of t equal to v naught v of t naught exist cheyum engil v is continuous at t naught ennu parayam. That is, here v of t is a vector function, so it has components. That is, v of t can be written in the form of v1 of t, v2 of t, v3 of t. It has three components. In two space it has two components. Then if v of t is continuous at t naught, then each component of v of t, that is v1 of t, v2 of t, v3 of t, etc., are continuous at t naught. That is, v of t is continuous at t naught if and only if its three components continuous at t naught. For example, v of t equal to xi plus yj plus zk is a vector function. In this vector function, the three components are, first component is x, second component y, and third component z. These three components are polynomials function. Therefore, we know that every polynomial functions are continuous. Therefore, each component x, y, z are continuous. Therefore, v of t is a continuous vector function. Next is derivative of vector function v of t. If limit delta tends to 0, v of t plus delta t minus v of t divided by delta t exists, then v of t is said to be differentiable at t. Also, if v of t is differentiable at t, then v dash t can be written as v1 dash of t, v2 dash of t, comma v3 dash of t. This is a problem. Find the partial derivative of the vector. First vector y square, z square, is x square. Second, xy, yz, zx. Here we have to find the partial derivative of each vector. First question, partial derivative of y square, z square, x square. First, we find the partial derivative of the vector with respect to x. That is, we differentiate this vector with respect to x only. Partial derivative edukkaanu vachal ipo x ilana partial derivative cheyyunnathengil baaki ella variables constant aayittu assume cheyyum. Here x and x is a variable and y and z are constants. So differentiating y square with respect to x imply 0, since y square is a constant. Next, differentiating the second component z square with respect to x, that is also 0. Now differentiating x square with respect to x, that is 2x. Then partial derivative of this vector with respect to y, that is, first differentiating first component with respect to y is 2y. Differentiating second component gives 0. Differentiating third component is 0. Next, differentiating this vector with respect to z, differentiating first component gives 0. Differentiating second component is dependent of z, therefore this is 2z. Then last, third component is 0. Differentiating x square with respect to z is 0. Next question, find the partial derivative of xy, yz and zx. First, differentiating that vector,
പാർഷ്യലി വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു എക്സ്. പാർഷ്യലി വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു എക്സ് ചെയ്യുക എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ ബാക്കിയെല്ലാ വേരിയബിൾസും കോൺസ്റ്റൻസ്. ദെയർഫോർ ഫസ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണന്റ് എക്സ് വൈ ആണ്, അവിടെ എക്സ് വേരിയബിളും വൈ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്. അപ്പം ഈ ഫംഗ്ഷന്റെ ഈ ഫസ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണന്റിന്റെ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് എന്ത്? വൺ ഇൻറ്റു വൈ, വൈ ഈസ് എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്. ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണന്റ് വൈ ഇസഡ്, ദിസ് ഈസ് ഇൻഡിപെൻഡന്റ് ഓഫ് ഇസഡ്, സോ ദ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഈസ് സീറോ. ആൻഡ് തേർഡ് കമ്പോണന്റ് ഈസ് ഇസഡ് എക്സ്, ഹിയർ ഓൾസോ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് എക്സ് ഈസ് വൺ ഇസഡ്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് പാർഷ്യൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് വെക്ടർ വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു വൈ, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഡിഫറൻഷിയേറ്റിംഗ് ദീസ് വെക്ടർ പാർഷ്യലി വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു വൈ. ദെൻ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് ഫസ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണന്റ് എക്സ് വൈ വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു വൈ, ഹിയർ എക്സ് ഈസ് എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്. ദെൻ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് എക്സ് വൈ ഈസ് എക്സ്. ഡിഫറൻഷിയേറ്റിംഗ് ദിസ് കമ്പോണന്റ് വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു വൈ ഗീവ്സ് ഇസഡ്. ഡിഫറൻഷിയേറ്റിംഗ് ദിസ് കമ്പോണന്റ് വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു വൈ ഗീവ്സ് സീറോ. ദെൻ ഡിഫറൻഷിയേറ്റിംഗ് പാർഷ്യലി വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു ഇസഡ്, ഫസ്റ്റ് കമ്പോണന്റ് ഈസ് ഇൻഡിപെൻഡന്റ് ഓഫ് ഇസഡ്, ഇസഡ് ഇല്ല, സോ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഈസ് സീറോ. സെക്കൻഡ് കമ്പോണന്റിൽ വൈ ഇസഡ്, അപ്പോൾ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് ഇസഡ് ഈസ് വൺ, ദെൻ വൈ ഇസ് ദ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് സെക്കൻഡ് കമ്പോണന്റ്. ദെൻ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ് ഓഫ് തേർഡ് കമ്പോണന്റ് വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു ഇസഡ്, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് എക്സ്. ദിസ് ഈസ് ദ പാർഷ്യൽ ഡെറിവേറ്റീവ്സ് ഓഫ് വെക്ടേഴ്സ്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഈസ് വെലോസിറ്റി ആൻഡ് ആക്സിലറേഷൻ. വി നോ ദാറ്റ് വെലോസിറ്റി വി ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് ചേഞ്ച് ഓഫ് ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ്മെന്റ്. ഇഫ് ആർ ഓഫ് ടി ഈസ് എ വെക്ടർ ഓർ ദ ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ്മെന്റ്, ദൻ റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് ചേഞ്ച് ഓഫ് displacement can be denoted as dr of t by dt, which is equal to r dash. Then speed, speed is not a vector quantity, also we know that speed is the rate of change of distance, so that is ds by dt, which also can be find out by the formula mod v or norm v equal to square root of r dot r dash dot r dash. Then acceleration, acceleration is a vector quantity, also acceleration is the rate of change of velocity, that is d by dt of v of t. We have v of t equal to rate of change of displacement, that is d by dt into d by dt of r of t, that is d square by dt square of r of t, which is equal to r double dash. So we can find the velocity, speed, acceleration using this formula for a vector function. An example is given. Consider the vector function r of t equal to r cos omega t I plus r sin omega t j. Then find the velocity, speed and acceleration of that vector function. We know that velocity v is the rate of change of displacement, that is r dash, and speed mod v equal to square root of r dash r dash dot r dash. Acceleration equal to r double dash, that is differentiating this r of t we get the velocity, differentiating two times this r of t we get the acceleration, then the dot product of r dash into r dash within the square root is gives the speed. That is, first derivative of r equal to minus r first derivative of r of t, that is r is a constant, derivative of cos omega t is minus sin omega t into omega plus r into r is a constant, derivative of sin omega t is equal to cos omega t into omega. That is r dash of t equal to minus r omega sin omega t I plus r omega cos t j. Next, acceleration is the second derivative of r. That is, we can differentiating r dash once more. Minus r omega into derivative of sin omega t is cos omega t into omega. That is minus r omega square cos omega t I plus r omega into derivative of cos omega t is minus sin omega t into omega. That is sin omega t into minus 1 omega square. We can take minus omega square common into r omega, r cos omega t I plus r sin omega t j. This is the given vector r, that is minus omega square r equal to r double dash is the acceleration. Next, we have to find the speed. We know that speed equal to square root of r dash dot r dash is, that is square root of r dash dot r dash. We have r dash equal to minus r omega sin omega t plus r omega sin omega cos omega t. Then r dash into r dash is the first product of first component, that is minus r omega t omega sin omega t into minus r omega sin omega t equal to r square omega square sin square omega t. Then next component in the product, that is r omega t cos omega t into r omega cos omega t equal to r square omega cos square omega t. That is r square omega square is common, taking outside, into sin square omega t plus cos square omega t, which is equal to, this is an identity, which is equal to 1. Then square root of r square omega square equal to r omega is the speed. Next is gradient of a function. Gradient of a function is represented as grad f or del f, where f is a scalar function. The gradient f is a vector function, is defined by gradient f equal to dou f by dou x into I plus dou f by dou y into j plus dou f by dou z into k, where del is the differential operator equal to dou by dou x I plus dou by dou y j plus dou by dou z k. Then dou f equal to dou f by dou x into I plus dou f by dou y into j plus dou f by dou z into k is the gradient f. Next is directional derivative. Directional derivative: the rate of change of f at any point P in any fixed direction given by a vector B is defined by directional derivative, given by the directional derivative of f at P in the direction of B, and is denoted by dBf, and is dBf equal to df by ds equal to limit s tends to 0 f of q minus f of p divided by s, where q is a variable point in on the ray c in the direction of b, where s equal to distance between p and q. Then directional derivative: The rate of change of f at any point p, that is, e p എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ പോയിന്റിൽ ഉള്ള f ന്റെ rate of change in the direction given by a vector b, that is, this is a vector b. p എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ പോയിന്റിലെ f ന്റെ rate of change in the direction of p is called the directional derivative of f at p and is denoted by db at f. And it can be found out by df by ds, where s is the distance between p and q, where q is any point in the ray, which is equal to limit s tends to 0 f of q minus f of p divided by s. And also, it can be found out by dou f by dou x into x dash plus dou f by dou y into y dash plus dou f by dou z into z dash. Other formula, direction derivative of f in the direction of vector a equal to 1 by norm a into a dot gradient f, where a is any vector. This is also another formula. Next question, find the gradient f and its value at p. F equal to x square minus y square, p equal to minus 1, 3. We know that gradient f equal to del f equal to dou f by dou x into y plus dou f by dou y into j plus dou f by dou z into k. Here, first component differentiating f with respect to x, that is 2xi. Then, second component is dou f by dou y is minus 2y. Then, dou f by dou z. Here, z is absent. Therefore, partial derivative of f with respect to z is 0. That is 2xi minus 2yj plus 0k. At p equal to minus 1, 3. Gradient f equal to minus 2i minus 6j. That is del f equal to minus 2 minus 6. Next question. Find the gradient of the function f equal to xy at p equal to 1, 1. Gradient f equal to grad of. Then first component is differentiating partially f with respect to x gives yi. Plus second component gives differentiating f partially with respect to y is x. That is xj. Then del f at 1, 1 equal to I plus j, that is del f equal to 1, 1. Next question, find the gradient of f of the function log x square plus y square at p equal to 2, 0. Del f, first component is the partial derivative of log x square plus y square with respect to x, that is log x in the derivative 1 by x. Here 1 by x square plus y square into 2x I plus second component is derivating differentiating log x square plus y square partially with respect to y, that is 2y by x square plus y square into j. At 2, 0, this is 4i by 4 plus 0j, that is I, that is del f equal to 1, 0. Next, f equal to x square plus 9y square at p equal to minus 2, 2. Del f equal to 2xi plus 18yj, that is first component getting from differentiating f partially with respect to x, and second component is differentiating f partially with respect to y. At minus 2, 2, del f equal to minus 4i plus 36j. That is del f equal to minus 4, 36. Next, find the gradient and the directional derivative of the given function f of x by z equal to 2x square plus 3y square plus z square at the point P equal to 2, 2, 1, 3 in the direction of the vector a equal to I minus 2k. First, we have to find the gradient f. Gradient f is equal to first component getting from differentiating f partially with respect to x, that is 4x. Then second component getting from differentiating f partially with respect to y, and the third component differentiating f with respect to z partially, that is 4xy plus 6y j plus 2zk. At p equal to 2, 1, 3, gradient f equal to 8i plus 6j plus 6k. Then direction derivative of f at a equal to, we use the formula 1 by norm a into a dot gradient f. Here 1 by norm a, we know that a equal to I minus, a equal to I minus 2k. Then norm a equal to root of 1 square plus minus 2 square, that is 1 by root of 1 plus 4 into I minus 2k dot 8i plus 6j plus 6k. Dot product in the varayanad, component wise multiplication, that is here I component multiplication 8 into 1. Then j component multiplication 6 into 0. Then third k component multiplication 6 into minus 2, that is minus 12, that is 8 minus 12 divided by root 5 equal to minus 4 by root 5. Here the minus sign indicates that f decreases at the point P in the direction of A. That is,
find the directional derivatives. First question, f equal to x square plus y square at the point P equal to 1, 1 in the direction of A equal to 2A minus 4J. We use the equation direction derivative of f in the direction of a equal to 1 by norm a into a dot gradient f. First, we find gradient f equal to del f equal to dou by dou x into I plus dou by dou y f into j. That is, here f equal to x square plus y square. Therefore, dou f by dou x equal to 2x and dou f by dou y equal to 2y. That is 2xi plus 2yi. Then del f at 1, 1 equal to 2i plus 2j. That is, here x equal to 1 and y equal to 1. That is equal to 2i plus 2j. Now given a equal to 2i minus 4j, then norm a equal to square root of 2 square plus minus 4 square. That is equal to square root of 4 plus 16 equal to root 20. Then direction derivative of f in the direction of 2i minus 4j equal to 1 by root 20 a dot del f. That is 2i minus 4j dot del f 2i plus 2j. Then this dot product equal to component wise multiplication. That is, first I component multiplication 2 into 2 4. Then j component multiplication minus 4 into 2 minus 8, which is equal to minus 4 by root 20. Root 20 can be written as 2 root 5 equal to minus 2 by root 5. Next question, f equal to x minus y at the point P equal to 4, 5 in the direction of 2y plus j. First, we find del f at 4, 5. Del f equal to I minus j. That is, first component is fx. That is, differentiating f with respect to x. That is I minus differentiating f with respect to y. That is minus j at 4, 5 equal to I minus j. Given a equal to 2i plus j, then norm a equal to square root of 2 square plus 1 square, that is 4 plus 1 equal to root 5. Then direction derivative of f in the direction of 2i plus j equal to
1 by root 5, that is 1 by norm A into A dot del F, that is 2i plus j dot I minus j. Then component wise multiplication, 2 into 1, that is 2. 1 into minus 1, minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1, that is 1 by root 5. Next is divergence and curl. Consider a vector.